Now, there is more and more research coming out about temperature and its effect on blood pressure. They basically found that for every 1 degree Celsius drop in room temperature, basically our systolic blood pressure would increase by 0.48 millimeters of mercury, and our diastolic blood pressure would increase by 0.45 millimeters of mercury. In this study, they examined about 4,659 participants and really analyzing their home room temperatures. The moral of the story is that the colder your home is, the higher the blood pressure readings they were getting compared to warmer homes. So I guess this suggests that we should all keep our homes adequately heated at a constant temperature, perhaps using your thermostat at home. This takes me back also to a story about a patient. I remember once doing a home visit, and this patient's home was really, really warm. Their house was about 30 degrees Celsius. When I looked at the thermostat at their house, that's about 86 Fahrenheit, I think. I've got it written down. So their blood pressure was always much lower at home compared to in clinic. And you know, this perhaps is one of the reasons for those blood pressure readings. So next question is, what temperature should one keep their home at? I personally think that most homes should be kept at about 21 degrees Celsius. That's about 70 Fahrenheit. Here at A&D Medical, I don't know if you know this, but we actually invented the digital home blood pressure monitor back in 1977. This in my hand is the A&D Medical Precision Check Pro device. It's one of our newer devices. This blood pressure monitor actually records the ambient room temperature as well when you are taking your blood pressure reading. So if you have any outliers that just look a bit strange compared to what you usually get, you can then correlate if there was a temperature change that could have affected it. Our technology is designed to give you even more confidence in health tracking. A&D Medical, discover precision.